in the previous session, we will see the what will be the syllabus for the electrostatics. Okay, now let's move on to the what will be the introduction for the electromagnetic waves and as well as the transmission lines. Okay, here our subject will be the E dot M dot W dot T dot L. Okay, here in this E represents the electrostatics. Okay, M represents the magnetic. Here this T represents the waves. Sorry, this W represents the waves, and this T represents the TL represents the transmission lines. Transmission lines. So, in this subject, we are mainly dealing with electrostatics and as well as the magnetostatics. In the waves, what we have to do means we have just combined this electrostatics plus magnetostatics. We will see the some important characteristics. Whatever we combined this electrostatics as well as the magnetostatics, that main relationships we have seen in this waves. Okay, after the waves we will move on to the practical applications, that will be the transmission lines. Okay, whenever we are using this electrostatics, magnetostatics as well as the waves, how we can implement it in the practical world. Okay, that means in this subject we will deal with the transmission lines. Okay, in our next semesters we will try to see the extension of this EMTL subject, that will be the antennas in the 3.1 and as well as the for microwave engineering in the 3.2. Okay, in this subject the application be the antennas. That antennas we will see in the next class, and microwave engineering we will see in the another class. Okay, so here the subject of electromagnetic phenomena in the book is done by the Maxwell's equations. Okay, in the olden days this electrostatic subject as well as the magnetostatic subject has to be started in the 1800s. Okay, in that time there will be scientists like Coulombs as well as then Gauss. What they will be doing means they will be writing a lot of paras based on their thoughts and their based on their experimental analysis. Okay, so what we have to do means we can't study that much of theory as well as the analysis. What our hero of the subject, that will be the Maxwell, has to be doing means he will be just used that theory, and that the theory has to be combined to the mathematical equations. Okay, so we are doing a lot of analysis based on electrostatics as well as in magnetostatics, and we will finally conclude it with four equations. That will be the del dot D is equal to rho v, del dot B is equal to 0, del cross E is equal to minus rho v by dou t, and as well as the del cross H is equal to J plus rho d by dou t. Okay, here this D represents the electric flux density, OV represents the volume charge density, and here B represents the magnetic flux, and here this E represents the electric field intensity, and as well as this B represents the magnetic flux density, and here H represents the magnetic field intensity, and this J represents the current density, as well as this D represents the electric flux density. Okay, these four equations the world has to be ruled out by using these four equations. Okay, so whenever he solved these four equations, okay, by using those scientists' analysis, based on that equations only we have to be seen in the practical applications like resistors, capacitors, and as well as in this KCL as well as then KVL has to be also be derived from this our subject only, that will be the EMTL. Okay, whenever we have to be solved some couple of concepts and as well as in some equations we will be in solved the KCL. Okay, then only the our network analysis subject will get started. Okay, at the lot of the concepts in the last session I will be tell you we have to be ended our syllabus with the capacitance, right? Okay, at that how the capacitance has to be done, we have to be seen in this electrostatics. From the capacitors as well as in inductors as well as in resistors, only this electrical subjects will get started. And here our in the electronics domain, this EDC as well as in analog circuit subject will get started. So what I am telling means, for all the engineering subjects, this EMTL subject will be the base subject. Okay, from that EMTL subject only, all of those subjects will get derived. Okay, how we can know? You are telling only for these subjects only these concepts has to be derived and our technology has to be arrived. Okay, whenever we have to be solved the lot of analysis, mathematical analysis based on the electrostatics as well as in magnetostatics, then you will get to know how that subject has to be started. Okay, this EMTL subject will be the godfather of all this. Okay, this will place in so much of crucial role. And where we can started this subject means, we don't know anything. In the 1800s and 1850s, we don't know this much of technology, okay, like automation technology as well as in control systems, linear control systems technology as well as in our digital circuits technology, that technology we don't know, as well as in chips and as well as the manufacturing technology, we don't know at that time that much very well. Okay, at that time what they will be doing means, they will be started with some basic analysis. Okay, they will be just making a thought and try to implement the thought based on some real practical applications. Okay, whatever the results they will be given, that from that results only they have to be moved on to the further concept. So here how they will be started, that ideas as well as the concepts for this EMTL subject, that be the, for example, this be the pen. Okay, if you want to take this be the cap, right? So this cap, if you want to put in a space, okay, if you want to put this cap in the space, if you want to put this be the space, for example, if you try to consider this be the space, if I want to just put my cap in the space, so here if I want to just put this cap in the space means, this cap in the space, this be the infinite, right? The space means infinite. How you can, if you want to take the distance, how you can take the distance in the space, it is impossible to take the distance. Okay, why? Because if you want to see the all of the axis, remaining axis, that will be the same only. Okay, how you can do means, for example, if you want to put this cap in the space, if you want to target be the, if you want to find out the distance from the cap to at your place, okay, how you can do in the space, it is not possible. At that time what we have to do means, we can't do this cap in the space without using the some appropriate coordinate system. Okay, appropriate coordinate system means, by using the coordinate system only we have to be easily derived this cap, how much the distance from the cap to your origin. Okay, this requires the appropriate coordinate system. Okay, when if you can't take the appropriate coordinate system, it can't be possible. Why? Because it be the space. Space means it be from the minus infinite to plus infinite, it will be always from the infinite. If you want to solve the infinite, it will be not possible, right? Here how you can take this be the cap. Okay, I am putting the here. So if I want to just take in some appropriate coordinate system, this be the some x axis, this be the some y axis, and here this be the some z axis. Okay, what I have to do means, I have just concatenate myself and just to put this cap here. Okay, Now it is possible, easy possible to find out the cap to the origin. For example, this will be the cap. Okay. What you have to do? You have to, this will be the origin. You have to just draw the straight line from origin to some cap. This distance will be the r. So in this way, you can easily solve any type of object by using the appropriate coordinate system. So in the before playlist, we will start the signal system subject, right? At that subject, we will try to see there also. We have to try to see the take the space as well as then time our as in one coordinate system. Okay, where you can see in the signal systems, what you have to do means this be the some y-axis. For example, if you take, you have to be always taken your x-axis be the time period in the signal system subject, right? But in this electromagnetic subject, we can't take time period be the our one of the axis. Here we can take all those axes that be the space only. Okay, in this electromagnetic subject, we have to be taken x-axis, y-axis as well as in z-axis. Okay, this x-axis, y-axis as well as in z-axis must be the perpendicular. Okay, so we have to describe the spatial variations. Spatial variations means whether you have to be taken the which axis you have to be considered. That will be the space. By using the space you have to be considered, or by using the time period you have to be considered. But in this electromagnetic subject, we have to be move on with the space only. Okay, of the quantities, we must be able to define the points uniquely in the space of suitable manner. Okay, right? In this way, we have to be put our suitable manner. Okay, this requires an appropriate coordinate system, right? Yes, this be the coordinate system, this be the appropriate coordinate system. Okay, for example, this be the pointer. Okay, I will be telling this cap be the point, or suppose this be the vector. Okay, if you want to represent it, this cap by using the in the space, how you can represent it by using the some appropriate coordinate system. In the some cases, it will be by using the curvilinear coordinate systems also be possible. Okay, in any curvilinear coordinate system, which may be the orthogonal or non-orthogonal. Okay, what will be the importance for then orthogonal? Orthogonal means it will be in a divided our x-axis and y-axis with 90 degrees. That be the important for the orthogonal. So for example, if you take this be the x-axis and this be the y-axis, so it will be divided our x-axis as well as the y-axis by 90 degrees. Okay, whenever it will be divided our x-axis and y-axis with 90 degrees, it will be the mutually perpendicular. Okay. So in this total electrostatic subject, we will mainly dealing with the this orthogonal coordinate systems only. Okay, it can't be in the non-orthogonal most of the cases. Okay, it will be the orthogonal only. That means if you want to take the x to y axis, the angle must be the 90 degrees. If for example, if you take the x to z axis, also the angle must be the 90 degrees. For example, if you take it from z to y axis, the angle must be the 90 degrees. Okay, this was then important term introduction for then electrostatics. In the next class, we will try to see the what is meant by scalar and what will be the important examples for this scalar, how we can define the scalar. And in the next class, we will try to see the what will be the vector and what will be the important examples for the vector. Okay, thank you.